Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking.
What up, friends? It is Friday night, and you know what Friday night smells of? It smells of pizza. Tonight is the night. And last time I got a kebab pizza, which people, they definitely told me that's definitely not a kebab pizza. I think today, friends, I've got the right combination. This is called a super kebab pizza. I'm pretty excited to try it, but it's kind of such a weird combination to me of all the things that are on here. Take a look. It's basically a kebab. There's chips on top, pickles, onions, tomato, pepperonki. I can't remember what they're called. In Sweden, why don't you cut the pizza? Like, why do you have to inconvenience us like that? I want conveniently delivered to my door and conveniently cut up into 8 to 6 slices. That would be, it would be key.
Sweden, you can change.
I got a few sauces with this. We're gonna put it on and we're gonna rate this 1 to 10. Let me know in the comments if this is the real kebab pizza. This just kind of looks unreal. So we've got a little pizza cell here, which I think is pretty typical in Swedish pizza culture. I'm just gonna chuck it on top. Is that what you do with it?
We'll mix it all around.
Kebab sauce. Lay that on there. I did have some spicy sauce, but it didn't survive the trip. Now this pizza looks pretty epic in the end. Like, yeah, seriously, a contender with one of the coolest pizzas I've seen. Let's give it a taste and rate it 1 to 10. You've made me do this, Sweden. You have made me do this. What a good combination. It's got the meat, it's got that kebabby meat, that weird flavored meat that you, tastes really good and salty, but you don't really know what it is. It's got some sauce. But honestly, I'm a bit uncomfortable holding it like this, so I'm gonna chop it up and we'll get to the middle of this. So we're here with a beautiful slice of pizza. We've got the chips on there. We've got the meat. We've got the all of the sauce and the salad on top. We're gonna give it a go. Good combination. The meat, I don't know about the chips on there, but they work somehow. The meat is delicious. Tomato-y based. And it's not like real thick. Basically, you imagine a kebab. With a tomato-y sauce, and this is what you got. I rate it. I really rate it. Super cool invention. Thank you, Sweden. This is my Friday night. We're gonna play some Mortal Kombat with the boys. I'm gonna enjoy this. Kebab pizza, well, this kind in this style has to be an 8 out of 10. Would try again and would recommend to my friends. Tomorrow is gonna be a little bit of a different day. I'm gonna try for the first time the banana pizza, the one that everyone talks about. Stay tuned for that because things are gonna happen. But first, I gotta have this night. Go to work and I'll see you tomorrow. Good night, happy weekend, my friends. Talk to you soon.
We should go on a Tuesday.
Yeah.
On the way to work, my friends. Can't actually film in work, but I found a solution. This is day 13 in a row of working. It's been a busy week, so I haven't had a chance to make any videos. Looking forward to tonight's pizza. I think it's kind of a scary idea, but yeah, see you at work. In a strange turn of events, it seems our boss is buying us lunch, so we're going to a restaurant right now, and because it's outside of work premises, I can film it. So looking forward to what we're going to order. Maybe it's a lunch buffet. Who knows? That's all part of the excitement. Then later on, strange banana pizza. But for now, it's lunch. I'm so tired. We're at a lovely place called Maskrill. Maskrillin.
Yeah!
Yeah, I made the vlog, guys. It's a very important day. There's not so much typical Swedish food here, so I got something more Australian, I think, as a burger with egg and bacon. Got this.
Ramlos.
Trocadero. But I got the 01. Trocadero? Never tried it in my life. Seems to be everywhere. Is it like the Coca-Cola of Sweden? Let me know in the comments. Sorry. Cheers.
Cheers.
Tastes like cola. Ginger ale. Maybe the normal sugar one probably tastes better. I don't know if I'd drink that again. Oh, the bubbles. 3 out of 10. What should I try next? Let's wait for lunch. My hands are clean. I don't know if you saw it in that last frame, but they were pretty f***ed up. Burger looks unreal. Sorry, it's not Swedish. We're gonna rate it anyways. Everything you need in a burger. Except after all this gluten, I'll probably be farting. So, this burger, as amazing as it is, come with some chips. It's getting a 7 out of 10 for me. See you for dinner time. The banana pizza. The monstrosity of all creations. If you're Italian, stop watching now. It's dinner time, but today's a little bit different. We're gonna go to a restaurant. And this is my last day in Alvesta, which was a little bit sad. I'm in the mood for some food. We're at this place, Vicent Grill and Bar. Let's try it out. Friends, I have ordered something called the Vincent Special, which for the value of the content, I wanted to get a bit of everything. There wasn't that many Swedish things on the menu, I'm so sorry. But this has like lamb, pork, beef, chicken, béarnaise sauce and some chips. You know what a funny thing is, I didn't really like béarnaise sauce until I moved to Sweden. Like béarnaise sauce is the best. It's like a creamy, it's not super sweet, it's a creamy, delicious condiment. Don't worry, anything. And when I order pizza as like a pizza sauce, I normally order béarnaise sauce. And I know I promised you the banana pizza, but tomorrow is the day I do it. I was a little bit scared. Didn't have it on the menu, doesn't matter. Tomorrow I will try it. I should try first some of the beef. Crispy, delicious, grilled. You can see the grill lines on there. You know it's been cooked on some charcoal or something. You can taste that barbecue flavor. It's unreal. I don't know whether to use my hands or not. We got chicken as well. Tzatziki dip. So juicy and delicious. We got some lamb, I think it is. And as I said to you, lamb doesn't come very often in my life.
That sounds weird. I'm gonna put some tzatziki on there. What's the flavor I've missed? Oh, unreal. And then we can try the pork. It's basically like a mixed grill, like a barbecue. There's a bit of everything. It cost me 30 euros. But for the video, I think, and for myself, I think it's worth it. I got the pork with a bit of mayonnaise. You know what I mean? You just buy grilled meat, and that's just exactly how you think grilled meat should be. That's this place. Vincent Grill and Bar in Ovesta. Unreal. I'm going to enjoy this with my friends, have a few more beers. Cheers to you, my friends. Tomorrow, we adventure out into the unknown and we try the banana pizza. And one day, I've got to try the Flying Jacob or Fliegen. How do you say it? Fliegen Jakob. Fliegen Jakob. I need to try that as well. But I got to find a place that does it. Or I got to make it myself. I'm going to enjoy this dinner. Have a great weekend. See you soon. 13 days since I last got a day off. Which doesn't really sound like too much, but it's like 11 hour days. So I'm stuffed. But today I'm moving from Ovesta back to Nyköping. So we're on a journey to find this banana pizza. We're on a journey to find something Swedish, because this video seems to be turning out to be not a Swedish video that I would have liked it to be. So let's drive. We got a 2.5 hour drive. We're on the road, my friends. Let's go.
Ditt nyckelfria lås. Med Yale får du inte bara smarta lås. Läs mer på yalehome.com.
Now moving into my new house in Nyköping. So we have like a 5-bedroom house, 6 bedrooms if you include one other little bit. And we have 8 people. So my goal right now is to get to this house and secure myself a bed for the next month while I'm still in Sweden. So to say the least, I'm nervous. The car full of 4 people is due to be there around the same time as me, so I'm just hoping it's gonna be okay. And then it's banana pizza time, so yeah. And I'll show you my new room, whatever room that may be. Maybe I'll be living in the kitchen, I don't know. So basically, my friends, if there is a blue car out the front of this house, I may have lost a room to myself for 4 weeks. Where 15 minutes later than they should have been. I hope they've gone to the shop, maybe. Hard to tell. Yeah, we're in Oxelösund. Oxelösund. And nearly there. But yeah, we'll see. I'll speed this up. And if you see a blue car at the end, just know I will be crying on my banana pizza. The other one, we're clear. Oh no. Literally the blue car is just here. I think I beat them. I'm gonna put something on my bed.
I feel bad that I didn't. They're looking for the house. But one. We're in before everyone. I done it. I sneaked them. They're on the street looking for some place. But I'm gonna go tell them that. Ow! Oh, I've just been walking really fast. I'm gonna tell them now where the house is. Hold on. Bye bye. So the reason I was a bit of a snake is because I wanted this room so I can read some books to my daughter. I think this is the child's room, and my daughter likes these books, especially this one. The little old lady who swallowed a fly. It's hilarious. Basically your classic old thing. But basically there's an old lady and she's like, she's stalking things
She eats the fly, then she eats a spider to eat the fly, then she, yeah, cool stuff. But anyways, I got the cool room, happy with that. We gotta sort out this dinner. Okay, friends, it's taken me, today is Tuesday, I was going to get the banana pizza on Sunday, and I pussied out, big time. Yeah, I've been kind of scared about ordering it, because it's just kind of such a weird combination, but I've decided it's Tuesday, and I decided that we need to try it today, and we need to try it now. Today, my friends, I have the banana pizza. Now this seems like such a strange combination to me. It's curry, it's banana, it's cheese, and it's banana. Like, super weird. Today I decided to bring some scissors. I thought it maybe it would be easier to cut a slice. But banana on a pizza, I've never seen this in my whole life. If you're Italian, turn your face around. I'm so sorry that this has happened. Yeah, we're gonna cut it down. Gonna cut ourselves a slice. Now I'm interested. I do like pineapple on a pizza, so I understand the little bit of the sweet contrast to a salty little meal. I understand. So I'm hoping that it's kind of like pineapple on a pizza. And this is what the slice looks like. You can see the little cooked banana on there. I wasn't really sure like how it was gonna turn out. It's taken me days to get to this point in my life, and we are here, my Swedish friends, and I'm glad I get to try some delicacies that your beautiful country has. Anyways, this is banana pizza. It's really sweet and really like, obviously it tastes like banana, because it's, well, it's banana, but, yeah, it's, I don't know. Like, it's not bad. It's not bad. You got the, you know, richness of the sauce. You got the fatty cheese. I got chinka or ham, chicken, and it somehow works. It's like, and it's not as prevalent or strong tasting, like it doesn't seem like it's out of place, but it certainly seems like it's out of place in my mind. The curry on there is really good. It seems like they maybe sprinkle some curry powder on top. I get that. It's good. It's delicious. Could I eat the pizza without the banana? I definitely could. Could I eat it with? Yes. Also, it wouldn't be my first choice, but it's actually not too unpleasant. Like, it's just sweet. It works with the saltiness. Combination weird, but overall it tastes good. I think everyone has to try one banana pizza in their whole life. What would I rate this out of? It's not my favorite. But to be honest, I don't like bananas, so, well, we were already going in the wrong direction. Pleasantly surprised. I'm gonna give it a 6.4 out of 10. Something that I probably wouldn't choose, but if it was there, I would probably eat it. And really, totally not overpowering. It's quite easy to eat. And yeah, I'm glad I got that done with. I was a bit more scared than that when I tried sisteroming. But no, it was actually not too bad. Thanks for the recommendation, my friends, and I will see you for another food video or something else. Depends on how much time I have. As I always say, drop me a comment, leave me a like, subscribe, and I will see you next time, my friends. Stay cool.
I'm going to ETS Adley on my bed.